Hey, and welcome back. So here we are in the second part of the toolbox overview. In the first video, we learned a little bit about the interface and some of the things you first see on your screen when you start up the program. Now, this part is still going to be about the interface, but more on the Microvellum palette and how to find the cabinets you need in the library to add to your drawings. First, start off by selecting the Projects tab inside of the Microvellum palette, and then select Projects. Okay, now we're back in the project viewer. Now, so far, we don't have any projects in here yet, just some empty folders. Now, this folder structure is great. It allows you to keep all your projects nicely organized by placing them inside of different folders or categories. The four categories underneath that main projects folder come with Toolbox. Now, you can use these if you want, you can rename them or just get rid of them. Just by selecting the folder and right-clicking opens up this menu. But for now, we're just going to leave them alone and go back up to the projects folder, select that, and right-click. Now, let's add a new category. So the category we're going to add here is going to be the one for all the projects that we're going to be creating during this training course. Let's name this one MVU Apprentice Series. So now this one category can be separate from all the other projects that you'll be working on outside of training. Okay, so we got that new category. Let's select that, right click, open up that menu, and now add a new project. Now we got to give this project a name. We'll call this one MVU underscore training underscore job one. And now hit OK. Now we have the project properties interface. So this is something that opens up every time you start a new project. Please don't just get in the habit of saving and closing it. This is the time that we have to enter all the general information that we know about the project. Now, hopefully you know something. I know that's not always the case as you first get awarded projects, but enter what you do know in here. And if you have to, just go ahead and make some assumptions. You can always go back and update it at a later date. So first we have the property names. Now these are used mostly when putting together drawings or documentation for the project, and you'll learn in upcoming videos how using this is going to save you a lot of time. For now, let's just start off by giving this project a description, and we'll call this one training. And now for the job number, let's go 0001, and then we can skip over the next few and go to general contact. So this gives you the option to pick from a list of all the different contacts that you have in your database. And then as you get to some of the other property names below, you'll have a list of all your employees that you can select from. You can add and edit these lists at any time by going under the Company Setup tab inside of the Microvellum palette. The process on how to do that will be covered in another video. For now, we'll just go ahead and select Microvellum and hit OK. And now skipping over the next few, we'll jump into the Project Wizard tab. Project Wizard allows you to control some of the different settings and specifications that'll be used for the cabinets inside of this project. So whatever information we enter here will be the way that the cabinets come in from the library. Now each project has their own specific project wizard, so these changes will only affect this project and not have any effect on any other ones that you're currently working on. You can see we're set up for dado and screw construction, so that means for this project, our cabinets are going to be dadoed and screwed. We're going to leave the default construction alone for now. We're just getting familiar with how this project wizard works and how our products look to this project wizard for instructions on how to draw and be built. Next, select the Project Setup tab. In the middle of the screen, you see some buttons. Those are called radio buttons. Let's make sure we have cabinet size defaults selected. And so now you can see the different cabinet sizes that are going to be used for this project. And now we go through our list and we tell the Project Wizard what sizes are our cabinets going to be for this job. So we only have a couple base cabinets we're going to draw on this one. So we're going to give our base cabinets a new height. Now, I apologize to all my friends out there that are using a metric library. Unfortunately, I have an imperial library, so everything we're going to be doing here is going to be in imperial. Okay, so this project, we're going to have our base cabinets finish off at 34 inches from floor to countertop. So now what does that mean for my base cabinet height? So I'm going to enter a value of 33 1/4. And if you're asking yourself, well, why don't you just enter 34? Because this property name is only telling my cabinet what size it needs to be from the floor to the top of the cabinet. It does not include the countertop. And if you're like, RJ, well, how are we supposed to know that? So what you can do is hover your cursor over these property names and a help bubble appears that lets you know exactly what value you should be entering inside of this text box. Now the next radio button, additional construction, takes you to some more options. Here we can change the number of shelves that are going to be used throughout the project for our base, tall, and uppers. And just so you know, this applies for the adjustable and fixed shelves on these cabinets. Toe kick assembly below that, there's a drop-down list that allows you to pick from different types of toe kick assemblies. We'll just leave this as adjustable legs for now. And then, of course, other options that you see in the middle, telling your cabinets how you want them to be built. Under the Material Options tab, you see we can select any buyout materials that we want for this project. But for example, if this job needed to have buyout doors on it, we would just check that box and let Toolbox know that this project has buyout doors. So the cut list that you're going to give me is only going to be for cabinet boxes, and provide me another list that I can send to my vendor to make all these doors for me. So just by checking that one box, lets Toolbox know how to proceed with this project. The other two tabs, title block info and render finishing options, we'll get back to later on. So let's now jump into our global variables. And similar to the project wizard, the global variables is also using all the settings that we had at our template. Now, hopefully you don't need to go into the global variables too often once you have a project started, but of course not every project is the same. So there may be a time that you need to go in there and change some of those deeper level settings. So you do have the option to do that here. Now under the project materials tab, this opens up all the different materials that are going to be used for this project. On the left-hand side of the screen, you see we have the pointer names and the current material. This is just a way for the software to know what material needs to be used for specific parts. On the right-hand side of your screen, you can see those yellow folders. That is the material library. So everything that we have inside of our library can be used for this project. It's just a matter of expanding some of those folders, finding the material, and reassigning it to those pointer names. Now for the next tab, to the right, we have Material Wizards. Select the Load Hardware Wizard button. Now this takes us into all the hardware that we're going to be using on this job. So you can see on the first tab, we have hinges. You can also go into the Mounting Plates tab and update any hinge plates. The handles and pulls, let's go into that one, and we are going to make a change on our base cabinet door. We're going to change the handle from a handle rod to just a standard wire pull. And you'll notice also that this is broken out by base, tall, and uppers. So it makes it easy if you want to make a change to just your base cabinets and not everything on your uppers, we can do that. By selecting that ellipsis button, it takes you into your hardware library. And similar to our material library, just a bunch of folders that have different pieces of hardware that we can use throughout this project. We're going to go into the wire folder. Let's expand that if it's not already expanded, and find our pull wire straight 4-inch. And then hit OK. And now we have a new handle for our base doors. You can go to the drawers tab and make any changes you want with your drawers, whether it be a different drawer type or a different drawer slide. Locks also, if they needed to be locks on this job, just a matter of checking one of those boxes. So as soon as I check the box for lock all doors, every door on this job is going to have a lock on it. And then depending on what lock I have selected here on the left-hand side, that'll be what Toolbox uses to give me what I need for this project. And then the additional hardware tab, if you need to make any changes for any other hardware that's being used. We want to make sure we hit that save and close, and yes, save those changes. It's time to add a new room. You'll notice on the Microvellum palette in that project tab, you can now add new room. So left click on that and then select the project, right click, add new room. We'll just call this one room one, hit okay. And now we have this window that appears that's asking us to select from a drawing template. Currently Toolbox offers two drawing templates to select from. We're gonna pick this Imperial Annotative drawing template. Now, drawing templates are something that can be customized and created as you get more into using Toolbox. But during this apprentice series, the Imperial Annotative drawing template really has everything that you need to get started. So that's what we're going to be working on for now. And then as we get into more intermediate level training, I'll show you how we can create and customize our own drawing template. Okay, so we got a room inside of our project. Now we're ready to start placing some products inside of this drawing. So select the Draw tab underneath Project. Now we're not going to add any room components yet. We're just going to go directly into Draw Products. And now you can see the list of cabinets inside of our library. So the first list that appears here are the master cabinets. These can be thought of as like starter cabinets or ones that you can use to create some custom or unique products. They're not going to be the ones that we use throughout this training course, although we will dip into it a little bit, but for the most part, just going to get into our frameless cabinetry category. So you'll notice there's two different ways to view all the cabinets inside of your library. One is by pictures and one is by the simple list view. And just another cool feature I wanted to point out was this search option. So in case you're looking for something, you're not able to find it, we have this option here for you. So let's just type in filler. You can see what I mean. So any product now with the name filler will show up in this list. and it'll save you a little bit of time from having to try to hunt that down inside of the cabinet library. So back into the list of our cabinets, let's go and select that pull-down menu next to the master cabinets, and this takes us back into our frameless cabinetry category. Now we're going to select our base cabinets and find our base one door. Now let's left click on the base one door and right click, and now this other menu appears. Now remember what I said, right clicking is kind of a theme throughout Toolbox, so there is another example of that. So now that menu appears, we have the options to place this product inside of our drawing. You can do it a couple different ways. If you had any walls in here, you can place them on a wall, but since we don't, we're just going to choose the one to place this product at a selected point. And now let's pick somewhere inside of model space and left click on your mouse to pick that point and place your cabinet. Once you've done that, we see this window appear. This is called our product prompts page. So these are all the different properties or all the different settings that you have for this one product. So this product you can see here is coming in at 20 inches wide. It has the height, depth, and all the other different settings for this cabinet. Let's go ahead and change the width to 30. And you'll notice below that we have the height at 33 1/4. That was the change that we made inside of our project wizard. You can see there's an example of how that link is working between the product and the project wizard. Anything on the right-hand side that has a checkbox is on, and if it's left blank, it's turned off. So you can see the add countertop is checked. So that means when we hit OK and we continue drawing this cabinet, it will come in with its own countertop. The other tabs on the top of the page will just go through all the other options that you have for this product. So internal options, you can see we can change what's inside of this cabinet. Currently, it's just an adjustable shelf. And the face options lets you change some settings on the door. And same goes for toe kick, countertop, and hardware options. But the only thing we're going to change on this one is the width of that cabinet and just let everything else draw as it is from the library. All right, now let's get a closer look and see what this cabinet's doing. So just by scrolling in on your mouse wheel, you can zoom in. And also by clicking and holding that mouse wheel, you can pan around on your screen. So when you see that little hand appear on my screen, that just means I'm in pan mode. And so clicking on the mouse wheel, holding it, and moving my mouse around allows me to reposition any objects that I have on my screen. And another way to get a good view at this cabinet is by changing it from a top view to a 3D view. Go to the top left corner in model space and select where we have the different views. Pick the one that says Southwest Isometric. Now you can see this cabinet in 3D and with its full machining. So this is another reason we selected the drawing preference to be 3D with full machining. So once these cabinets are drawn inside of model space, we can zoom into them and see exactly how they're going to be constructed. So everything is basically ready to go out to the shop and be constructed directly from the library. You can change the visual style to something other than a 2D wireframe just by selecting next to your views and changing that visual style. Now, just something to keep in mind as you're working in Toolbox, it's a good idea to always stay in that 2D wireframe. The conceptual or hidden or some of those other ones in there are great to use if you're not trying to show as much detail and just want to see a clear picture on what the product's actually going to look like. But when working and redrawing and drafting inside of Toolbox, it's always good to stay in that 2D wireframe. Otherwise, the program's just going to get really slow and take a lot longer to redraw. When we first draw this cabinet, we have the option to make any changes that we want. But after the product is drawn, what do we do next? Well, you can still go back into that prompts page just by going into the Microvellum palette again, underneath the Modify tab, and then Modify Products, selecting Product Prompts. Once you have that selected, you'll notice on the command line, you get the tip asking you to select which cabinet you'd like to modify. That little square pick box is active and ready to pick a cabinet. And select anywhere inside of this cabinet and open up that prompts page. And so this is what you would do once you get some cabinets drawn inside of the project and you need to come back and make some changes or interact with some of these products by turning some things on or off. You just go back into product prompts and do what you need. And now we're going to change the width to 16. And also let's give this cabinet a 2-inch filler. So underneath the left filler width, just type in 2. Under the internal options, we'll make that change. And instead of an adjustable shelf, we'll change it to a fixed. If you open up the hardware options, you'll notice the base handle type is the pull wire straight 4-inch. And then once you hit OK and let that cabinet redraw, you can see now those changes have taken effect. We got our filler turned on, the width went down to 16. And so now the next step is to add another cabinet to this project. So we'll repeat the same steps that we did before. Go back into our draw tab under the inside of the palette. And now find our base door drawer cabinets subcategory. And select that. And now select the base one door, one drawer, right click. And again, place this product at a selected point. You can zoom out a little bit in model space, pan over, just find a good spot to place this cabinet and hit okay. We're gonna let this just redraw with all the standard cabinet size defaults. And you'll notice with this cabinet, since it is a one door, one drawer, as we change our visual style to conceptual, it's easier to see that that handle on our drawer is different than our door. And that's again because of what we did inside of the project wizard. We only changed our base doors and not our drawers. Now the next step is going back into the project properties and making some changes. Now select the project wizard, project setup, go back into our cabinet size defaults. So instead of all these cabinets now being drawn at 33 1/4, we're gonna change this to 50. So now we're telling this project all the base cabinets are gonna be 50 inches tall instead of 33 1/4. Now that goes for any new cabinets that we draw, and it also goes for the ones that we have currently inside of this project. We'll make that change there. We'll leave everything else alone underneath the cabinet size defaults. Let's select the material wizards now and make a change to that handle on our drawer. So we also don't want our drawers to be a different handle type than our doors on this project. So we can go into the handle drawers under the handle pulls tab and go back and find that pull wire straight 4 inches. We'll save and close. And now we're back into model space. We see our two cabinets, but nothing's changed. So the way to see these cabinets get updated with the changes that we just made inside of the project properties is by going into the Microvellum palette and inside of the Modify tab. Now under Modify Products, and towards the bottom of the list, you see Redraw Selected Products. A little help tip at the command line, and it's now letting you know the next step is to select the products you would like to redraw. After you have your cabinet selected, hit Enter, and now this drawing style window appears to let you change or keep this current drawing style. Let's hit OK. We'll keep it as 3D, full machining. Now, if this looks familiar, and this is because we already saw this in Toolbox Setup under the AutoCAD options, it remembers that setting when we go back into the products after they've been drawn and select to redraw them. Now, if you were to make the change here to show something other than 3D full machining, that's fine. It's not going to affect anything else that will be drawn inside of this project. So it's only going to be specific to these two cabinets. So there you can see the height's updated. We now have taller base cabinets, and also the handle type on the drawer matches the door. And that's how we work with our project wizard to let our cabinets know inside of this project how we want them to be drawn and how we want them to be built. Now, one more time, let's go back into that one door, one drawer base cabinet, open up the product prompts. And you can see here on the main page, just confirming there's the height. You can see that is updated as 50 after the change was made to our project wizard. And on the right side of the screen, go ahead and check the box for a right finished end. Now that box is checked, that means it's on. Hit okay, and let this cabinet redraw. Now I want to take a look at the right side. Let's go back into our view. Now change it to a southeast isometric. Now before doing anything else, you can see just visually that the right side of that base one door, one drawer cabinet has changed in color. And that's just a quick way to let you know that the material's changed. So now we're looking to a finished end material instead of just our standard carcass part material. It not only uses a different material for the side of the cabinet, it's also adding an additional kickskin on the right-hand side to cover up those adjustable feet. As you work with Toolbox and continue to draw and take a look to see how some of these cabinets work and what kind of options you have for yourself, go through all the different tabs and change your doors and your internal options. Just play around with it. Have fun with it. This is a training project, and as long as you're staying at that project level, anything that you do in here, it's not going to affect anything else inside a Toolbox. Okay, so that wraps up this brief introduction to help you get a little bit more familiar with some of the things that we'll be doing during this training series. And now that we got those first couple videos of kind of showing you the way around the software behind us, we can now start working on some exercises that are going to take your skills when working with Toolbox to the next level. Thanks again for joining me on this journey throughout all these videos. I'm RJ, and I'll see you on the next one.